Hey, what's up, everybody? Hola, bienvenidos a Mexico. This is the Gringo with the Green Bag, and I'm back once again at the LA Travel and Adventure Show. I'm here with mi amiga, Sandra Felix. She's from the Tourism Board for La Paz in Mexico. How are you doing today, Sandra?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
I'm awesome, as always, full of energy, feeling the spirit of the fiesta right here in the Mexico booth. Today, we're here to talk about Baja California Sur. This is the specialist. If you want to know anything about Baja California Sur, La Paz, all the great destinations that you can find there, you're going to want to talk to Sandra. So what do you think about the travel show today?
It's amazing. We're learning about a lot of destinations and a lot of things to do in the world. But to be honest, nothing compares to Baja.
You know what? I'm going to take her word for that. I have not been to Baja California Sur. I've just been to Tijuana and Ensenada, Rosarito, some of the mainstream popular gringo destinations across the border. But we want to get into the heart of Baja California. There's no better place to go and really, really discover all the jewels and wonders of Baja California until you go way down Baja California Sur. Let's talk about some of those destinations that you are promoting today, some of the highlights of that area.
Of course. Well, everybody knows Cabo. Cabo is at the tip of the peninsula and is the tourist destination for excellence. But we have a lot of other things to do in Baja, especially if you start going up north. So our first stop would be Todos Santos, the legendary Todos Santos, where the Hotel California is. So some people say that's the hotel from the Eagles song. Some people say it's a lie. You have to come and see it for yourself and make your own opinion. And a little bit further up north, it's La Paz, which is the capital city of Baja California Sur. And it's in the Bay of La Paz, in the middle of the Sea of Cortez. And Jacques Cousteau named the Sea of Cortez the aquarium of the world.
Right.
Why? Because in one day, just one day, you can experience snorkeling with sea lions, with whale sharks, you can go diving with hammerhead sharks, you can see dolphins, mobular rays, it's, you name it, it's amazing. And that's what we like to sell in La Paz. We don't like to sell hotel rooms, we like to sell experiences. We want you to go out there and experience nature and experience the Sea of Cortez.
Well, I mean, it's got to be named La Paz, the peace, for a reason. I mean, I can imagine when you're down there, you're going to be totally at peace, totally relaxed. My friend Jorge Gamboa Pachon, everybody. Good to see you, my friend. Mi amigo Jorge, we love him. So, we're talking about La Paz, a place to go to unwind, relax. Tell us why La Paz is unique and special and different from any other destination that you have seen.
Okay, La Paz is unique because you have paseños. And paseños are amazing people that really make you feel at home. So it's still what we like to call it, an authentic Mexican city. So you come here and you can find all the comforts of a big city, but still Mexican. Like a gringo like you would have a hard time finding somebody that speaks English, but you won't have a hard time finding what...
No problema, no problema.
Habla español. Le gustan los crustáceos. Anyway, so it's still an authentic city. It's still Mexican. It's very family-oriented. But our main thing, it's adventure travel. So like I said, you have the Sea of Cortez where you can do all sorts of water sports. But you also have the desert. And you also have an oasis, which is Todos Santos. And you also have a sierra, like the Sierra de la Laguna. So you have all sorts of things that you can do. La Ventana is place number one to practice kite surfing in the world. So you have all these like different activities that you can do, and it's mostly for adventure travel.
It's a lot of adventure travel, relaxation, a lot of incredible landscapes from what I've seen in pictures anyway. I haven't been there yet, but it's on my list. Most people, they just go directly to Cabo, and it's a mainstream, popular destination. You look at the Baja Peninsula, and it seems like just one big desert, and from our conversation earlier, there's so many hidden treasures and jewels all throughout Baja California Sur. What are some of the towns outside of La Paz that specifically people should keep their eye on?
There's one, it's a old mining town, it's called El Triunfo, and one of the main things there is that the chimney for the mine was designed and built by Gustave Eiffel from like the Eiffel Tower. So you have that, and then you also have, like I said, Todos Santos, and then a little bit up north is the magical town of Loreto, and Loreto is a sanctuary for whales. So you can go see the gray whales, you can see the blue whales, you can see humpback whales. It's just amazing.
So what's the best time of year would you recommend for a first-time traveler down to Baja California Sur and to some of these specific destinations, specifically to catch those whales in action?
The best time, it's honestly, or my favorite time, I don't want to say the best time, but my favorite time, it's October. The weather outside, it's still warm, but not super hot, and it's not windy or chilly, and the water temperature is fantastic. So honestly, October, November, or even March and April and May, but my favorite time is October.
And are there any, throughout the year, are there any like specific festivals? I mean, Mexico's the king of festivals and fiestas, you know, no matter where you go. Is there any kind of things specific that's going on in Baja California Sur throughout the year that maybe of special interest?
Right. Well, first of all, we don't celebrate Cinco de Mayo. That is not our independence. Our independence is September 16th.
That's for gringos. I told you guys.
But anyway, we have an amazing music festival in Todos Santos that happens in January every year. It's organized and done by Peter Buck from REM, and he brings all his friends. So it's 2 weeks of fun music. Amazing. We also have the Whale Festival. So starting in December all the way till April, the gray whales come from Alaska all the way to Baja Sur to have their babies. So we have a big whale festival, and then you can go see the whales and interact with them, and it's amazing. I would say those are like our main events.
And for to access some of these places that you've mentioned, if people don't like long car rides throughout the desert, what would be the main jump off point? Would you fly to like Cabo San Lucas and then drive north from there?
That's the amazing thing. Los Cabos is, you know, it has a lot of direct flights from all over the states. And it's only an hour and a half drive from Los Cabos to La Paz. So it's nothing. It's really easy to get there. You can also find direct flights from Los Angeles to Loreto, and then you can drive down to La Paz or just stay in Loreto. But I would say the best way to do it is through Los Cabos.
Okay, now one of the most important questions for me personally, what kind of SPF sunscreen would a gringo like me need to go down there in the beautiful exotic deserts of Baja California Sur?
I would say zero. You need some color.
I need some color. That's what they tell me. I'll take that as a compliment. That's my indigenous pigment, and I'm going to roll with that. Anyway, we're having a great time with the travel show, a very successful show. I mean, from what I can tell, there's a lot of traffic here, a lot of interest in Mexico, specifically in Baja California Sur. It may be the next top destination. I know it's hot on my list. I'm going to get there as soon as I can, and I'm going to look at my friend Sandra when I do. She can show me the best of the best of all she has to offer and that all the Baja California Sur has to offer. Anything else you want to say to the fans, travelers out there? Any website links or social media links to get in contact?
Sure. Well, first of all, come and visit us in Baja, and our website is golapaz.com. Just come find us there, and you can see all the amazing things you can do there.
GoLaPaz.com. I am ready. I feel like I just got my passport stamped. Can't wait to go down there and live it. You got to live it to believe it. That's what we say in Mexico. Thank you for your time, Sandra. Wonderful interview. We'll see you in La Paz and Baja California Sur very soon.